morning.
Good morning.
I welcome you to the 15th anniversary celebration service of Bloom in the Desert Ministries, United Church of Christ, and Reconciling Ministries Congregation. As we have done since that first Sunday morning, we light a candle. And this candle is a symbol of the traditional understanding of that our scriptures have given us, saying Jesus is the light of the world. And we light this candle as a reminder in that way. We also know that in the scriptures, Jesus is said to have said, "You are the light of the world." And so as we light this candle, it represents all of us. And we are such that when it's extinguished at the end of our service, the illumination, the inspiration, the intention, the motivation, none of that goes out with the candle. It goes out these doors with you as you take this light from here and into the rest of our community and the world. It's good to be with you on this Sunday. I am a bearer of the welcome of Bloom in the Desert Ministries that has been intentional from the very beginning, that we would live, even before we knew what it was, the modern motto of the United Church of Christ that says, whoever you are and wherever you are in the journey of faith, you are welcome here. And so in the midst of that, we have understood from the beginning that people in God's creation come in many different forms, shapes, sizes, colors. We welcome people who are black and white and red and yellow and brown. We know that people love one another in a variety of ways, and we welcome people who are straight and gay and bisexual. We know also that God's created identity for each of us is not along a binary scale. And so we know that we welcome people who are transitioning, transgender, cisgender, people who are gender nonspecific, gender fluid. It is our intention always to welcome you as you see yourself from the inside out, rather than an identity.
Read Spring Fling,
or saw any of the marketing materials or the theme of Spring Fling, you'll remember it was "You Gotta Have Friends." And the main graphic element was hands, multicolored hands that were a part of that graphic element on the posters and cards and the program and so forth. So one of our members was inspired by those hands, and that is where this stole came from, and I was surprised with this week, and I think it's pretty wonderful and pretty representative of our ministry. And it goes along with my rainbow-colored intersectionality socks. So, we're all sorts of ways in which we're connected.
Please rise as you're able to the call to worship. This is the day our God has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
This is the day we celebrate the 15th anniversary of our first gathering for worship in the Rose Garden.
We know it's not about the place. It's about the people gathering in love's service.
We know it's about our relationship with God and each other, growing in faith and making real dream eternity.
This is the day our God has made. Now let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Shalom, shalom, Hinnom, Paz, Peace, Amen.
This is the time in our worship when in faith we open our hearts to ministry with our prayer for good and growth. Let us pray as a statement of our faith now and a call to action for our future.
Molder and shaper of earth, you build us the people loving one another, by loving others who love you. When we stretch ourselves in, remold us in vessels that can hold strength and nourishment. When we get pushed down, shape our courage to reach out kindness. You are the Potter, the Mender, the Eternal One who renews us. Help us carry the weight of personal responsibility to do what we can to live well and share your abundance.
Amen.
Loving source of all there is, wonderful counselor for every condition, everlasting companion to all, hear now our silent prayers. And let the people say Amen.
Amen.
Where there is light in the soul, there will be beauty in the person. Where there is beauty in the person, there will be harmony in the house. Where there is harmony in the house, there will be order in the nation. Where there is order in the nation, there will be peace in the world.
Amen. Let us now receive the word.
Morning.
Good morning.
The Hebrew scripture reading for today is Psalm 126. When Yahweh brought us captives back to Zion, we thought we were dreaming. Our mouths were filled with laughter then, our tongues with songs of joy. And from the nations we heard, their God has done great things for them. Yes, Yahweh has done great things for us, and we are filled with joy. Now set our captive hearts free, Yahweh. Make them like streams in the driest desert. Then those who now sow in tears will reap with shouts of joy. Those who go out weeping as they carry their seed for sowing will come back with shouts of joy as they carry their harvest home. Here ends the Hebrew scripture reading.
Please arise as you are able for the reading of the Gospel. The Gospel reading today is from the book of John, chapter 3, verses 16 and 17. Yes, God so loved the world as to give the only begotten one, that whoever believes may not die, but have eternal life. God sent the only begotten one into the world, not to condemn the world, but that through the only begotten, the world might be saved. Here ends the reading of the Gospel. This is the good news of Jesus Christ.
Thanks be to God. Amen.
Woo!
We are very grateful to stand here before you 15 years later after that first Sunday morning. I am thrilled that today we're able to have Mike Weldon and Richard and Ray and Joe and Ann and Mike Shear here with us as people that have, you know, what, are you here? He's got a cold, so he's mostly here. Here with us, you know, on this special day. It's also, and we'll remember together, you know, that there were other people in the Rose Garden with us, and some of them had to leave early because the sun was too bright, and it got too hot for them. I counted them before they left and turned in that report. The thing about it was what we needed is we needed trees to crowd in to provide shade on that day, as you have just so beautifully sung for us these words in this beautiful piece of music. We just needed that on that day. We're also grateful today to have our conference minister leader, our visioning leader from 2015, Reverend Dr. Felix Villanueva. Felix has been a good friend of Bloom since, you know, the very beginning of his being a part of our Southern California Nevada Conference of the United Church of Christ, and we're grateful for Felix making the trip today, and we're grateful for the words that he will bring, and also for the time that he will spend with us informally as we gather for hospitality afterwards. Let us pray. Bless us, loving God, for this time together is precious. We know you are blessing us. We don't even need to ask. We pray that as we share memories, that it is understood that we are also looking to the future. It is from the past that we grow. It is upon the past that we build. And we pray, loving God, that we continue to sense your guidance into the future as we have from the very beginning. Your guidance, your comfort, your care, your inspiration, bringing your peace and healing to people as we felt led to do. Continue to be with us and guide us and anoint us in this worship time, that the word that you have for us is able to find it to our hearts and minds among all the words we pray and sing and think. Know that we are looking to be people who are like people have been for so many thousands of years, people who want the meditations of our hearts and the words of our mouths, of my mouth, to be acceptable to you, O God, our rock and our redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
As I mentioned before, the very first message that Mike and I put out from Bloom in the Desert Ministries into the Palm Springs community was, the Bible is not a weapon of mass condemnation.
The first short phrase we would say as a theme sometimes when we met and talked with people was, you are loved.
So it is not only coincidental in the lectionary, it is right and good that the Gospel of John and the Gospel of John's scripture today includes the second and better half of the 16-17 duet. We usually only hear the first half. John 3:16 is a verse that we see and hear a lot. The inclusive Bible translation that you heard reads, yes, God so loved the world as to give the only begotten one, that whoever believes may not die. But I think the better half is the second half. And that half has been the model for our whole Bloom message and ministry since day one. God sent not the only begotten into the world God sent the only begotten into the world not to condemn the world, but that through the only begotten, the world might be saved.
In a Rev Kev paraphrase that I think any benevolent New Testament scholar would hear kindly, hear it this way. the eternal source of love and life, did not give the ministry of Christ Jesus to the world to condemn the world, but hopefully the world will be healed by it. Being the co-founders of Bloom and still being around means that we carry in our hearts, minds, and bodies much of the experience of starting this new church. Something for us to always remember is that in addition to the experiences we've had, there are many, many people who've had experience with Bloom and because of Bloom, and all of these combined are the totality of the Bloom in the Desert ministry story.
In some cases, it taught us how to handle and heal from toxic interactions. In all cases, we felt God was in the midst of us, and we were going to continue living by a motto that got us through many moments of hesitancy. We go with what we got and do the best we can. Has anybody heard me say that? We go with what we got and do the best we can. The vision, mission, and core values we share and publish on our website and in our Sunday Bulletin weekly are the foundations of our ministry. They are encapsulated in the words and phrases we use often to describe ourselves and our ministries. Welcoming, growing, progressive thinking, healing, innovative, adaptive, developing, blossoming, and connecting. And some of the greatest joys for us have been on the occasions of our first weddings and baptisms. Remember those? Some of the best examples of our being church together is when we've gathered to support a loved one and honored the life of our friends with Bloom Memorial Services. And we intentionally included this Sunday the photos of We Remember Friends on some of these panels of people, as we do on Memorial on All Saints Sunday, but we brought them today as they have been very much a part of our 15 years together. Our ministries are meaningful and greatly in alignment with the variations that we have as a congregation and as a community.
People may joke about this, but we like the annual meetings. Elections, leadership retreats, regional association meetings, and Southern California Nevada Conference participation. Because that shows we are part of something more. Plus, national offerings, Bloom anniversaries, and annual events show we are yet alive. Some of our most rewarding ministries come in Sunday worship and prayer, and weekly and monthly ministries of service and learning. These have been a lifeline many times as we learn from each other and show up for each other. Showing up to support peace and social justice actions has always been important to Bloom. We protested wars and blessed peace. We sought workers' rights and marriage equality. We marched for common sense and compassionate immigration reform. And from the very early days, we encouraged people to vote.
And as a social action and missions team, an open leadership team, and even as a congregation, we aligned ourselves to be the very first church in the state of California to go on record supporting the Compassionate Choices Act for death with dignity in the state of California. Now, the weddings of 2008 were a great time of witness and blessing. That's when we seemed to be the UCC same-sex marriage resource of the world. And people flew in and drove in and showed up and wanted to come and be married by the UCC minister in Palm Springs. And we will never forget our own wedding in Wayne and John's backyard on December 14th, 2013. We are always grateful for that congregational time of justice and love. Bloom has been a rewarding journey for us and a loving destination for many. All the steps along the way have not been easy. It's possible we have thicker skins, broader waistlines, and thinner hair as a result. One of us more than the other. Now that is what I learned in school, in Doctor of Ministry school. That is what theologians call the embodiment of faith. We are physical manifestations of the journey as well. And the further truthiness, as the great contemporary commentator Colbert would say, our truthiness is that everyone in this room is the embodied reality of this church on the journey in this moment. Look around and see how blessed we are by God. Now we look to the future, to the next 5 years, 15 years, and as I often say, 100 years. Reverend Dr. Felix Nueva, who has been with us on several occasions, returns to give us insight into the UCC of the future. We welcome Felix. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Amen.
What a great occasion, 15 years. I bring you greetings from the other 133 churches and 16,437 members that comprise the Southern California Nevada Conference of the United Church of Christ. And together we rejoice in this celebration with you. There's a couple parallels between Bloom and my own personal life. In March 2003, you were in the desert working on providing a Bible study on the Bible is not a weapon of
mass
condemnation. In March 2003, I was in Kuwait ready to invade Iraq looking for weapons of mass destruction. I was a Navy chaplain serving with the Marine Corps in charge of 23 chaplains from all walks of faith as we were getting ready to work on that unfair war. After that, I retired and came back to civilian life after 21 years of service. So there's a parallel there. Through all this time, I've been a conference minister for almost eight years. And by the way, you know what a conference minister is? I've been here twice. You should know the answer to this. You know what anyone who knows what a conference minister is, raise your hand. Really? Actually, that's the answer I always get. So I say, do you know what a bishop is?
Yes.
Yeah. Think of a bishop with absolutely no power. That's what a conference minister is. Actually, my job is equivalent to that of a bishop. I just don't have the authority. My role is to oversee and provide ministry and support what you do here in Palm Springs and throughout Southern California and Nevada. And our work is part of what you do. We develop leadership. We provide tools. We try to support you in every way we can so you can be successful as what you do here. So throughout those 8 years, I have seen Bloom from the beginning till today. And every year, RefCAF sends me your annual report. And every year, that's the only annual report I always read. I'm not kidding you. It's the only one that is really very interesting. Because you can see the line. It's been slow, but it's been successful. And you have something amazing here. You have brought springs into the desert. Springs of hope. You have created an amazing church in a place that everybody thought that you were going to fail because of the constant turnover of people. And yet, you remain faithful. And you are transforming lives here. So that's who you are today, when you heard the story. What about next? Next 5 years, next 15 years, and where are we going as the United Church of Christ? I think the best way to illustrate that is, with another personal illustration. I grew up Roman Catholic. How many Roman Catholics here? I grew up Roman Catholic until about age 16. Then we moved, and there was no Catholic church, so there was an evangelical church across the street, which I joined, because I've always been kind of connected to God in one way or another, or God has always been connected with me. So I became an evangelical. Through that process, I later on became a Pentecostal. You following the line here? Then I became an agnostic. In seminary. And then I found the United Church of Christ. An interesting journey. Well, let me tell you something. Those steps were valuable in my life. From the Roman Catholics, I learned that rituals and smells are very, very important. From the Pentecostals, I learned that when the Holy Spirit wants to speak, there's no one who can stop her from speaking. From the evangelicals, I learned that I have no excuse for not sharing the good news with everyone I meet. Good news of a God that loves us as we are, who created us whole and complete, and who loves us unconditionally. And from the agnostics, I learned that I have to question everything. And that's what brought me to the United Church of Christ. That's who you are, Bloom. That's who you are. Each one of you has a history. Each one of you bring gifts to the ministry of this church. That's what brought you here. That's what will take you into the future. That's how you'll move forward. When I talk to churches and I do visioning and missioning, and you heard Rev Kev talk about me doing one of those 3 years ago, which, by the way, that's the other reason I read your report, because I see that you actually are working the plan. We're talking about who are we going to be into the future. And there were all kinds of dreams and all kinds of expectations. And I always say that the future begins by looking into the past, but not living into the past. Hear the difference? I have some churches that are still in 1967, by the way. Because your past will determine your core values and determine your identity. So we look into the past and then we move forward. What do I see for Bloom into the future? I see a thriving community of faith, doing things outside the box, honoring tradition, honoring liturgy, honoring classical music, and all putting it all together in an amazing way in the most unexpected place in Southern California. And I see people coming and discovering the gift that you are. I saw in your report, and we had that conversation before, well, we need to be a multi-generational church. My question is, why? Why? Who is your community? We asked that question in our 3 years ago. You represent who lives in Palm Springs. Look around. You do. So, why do you want to be any different? Continue doing what you're doing. Continue reaching out to the marginalized. Continue giving a word of love to people who have never heard that God loves them the way they are. And you will continue to thrive from here on. You will outlive both Rev Kev and Mike and myself, and you will continue growing as this amazing church. Yeah, one way he'll have to leave. I'm sorry. Don't know when, but they have to leave. It's part of life. I have to leave. But you will remain. And the gospel of Jesus Christ will continue to be proclaimed here in Palm Springs through you. And people will respond, and they will come. And yes, Rev Kev, maybe Obama might show up one day. Friends, you have a great thing going on here. Happy anniversary, happy 15th. Keep on doing what you're doing, and God bless you.
Thank you. Dear God, we offer these gifts to your glory on this special day in the life of our church. We thank you for those who came together in response to your call to form this community. Grant us the grace and wisdom to continue flourishing as bloom in the desert. Amen.
Amen.
Now let us reach out and connect with one another in some way and join together and pray the prayer given to us from Jesus using the words most familiar and comforting to you, saying,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.